Hello and welcome to Thinking About the Bible. We're going to complete this thought that we started actually a few days ago. But we're going to look at verses 9 and 10. And obviously this continues to flow after that. We'll be covering that next week more. But verses 9 and 10 in Colossians chapter 2 read from the New King James, "For in him," meaning Jesus, "dwells all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and you are complete in him, who is the head of all principality and power." The New Living Translation says, "For in Christ lives all the fullness of God in a human body, so you also are complete through your union with Christ, who is the head over every ruler and authority." Now, this isn't to say that God is and Christ are kind of collapsed into one. The Orthodox position is that Jesus Christ is two natures in a single person, with no confusion of the two. And this, of course, is very difficult for us to understand. But what one thing we can pull out of this is that there is no access to God apart from Jesus Christ. And one of the things as a chaplain, especially, I see this a lot, people talk a lot about God. "Oh, I have a good relationship with God. I have this and that." And they never mention Jesus Christ. And I don't, you know, I can't judge a person's understanding or belief, but that sets up some red flags. Because if a person is talking about their relationship with God and you know, this and that and everything, and how they really feel close to God and whatever, but never mention Jesus, they're missing something, at least in their teaching. Even if they have a relationship with God in Jesus Christ, and if they can't express that, even in an elementary way, then there's something wrong, because there is no access to God, the Almighty, apart from Jesus Christ. That's one of the things that we know here. "For in him dwells all the fullness of the Godhead bodily." It isn't as if God, you know, he's kind of trying to stuff him. I mean, we think physically. And so if you visualize that as God is trying to get stuffed into this single person, and there's some of him that doesn't fit. And so you can access God some other way. Well, Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by or through me," Jesus Christ. So Paul is saying the same thing here, really, in a different way, that the fullness of the Godhead is found in Jesus Christ. He is the only means by which we have fellowship with God. It's not possible to fellowship with God apart from Jesus Christ. It is not possible to have fellowship with God apart from Jesus Christ. That's something we can't, that's non-negotiable. There's no way around that. You can't suggest. Now, I remember years ago, I was talking to somebody who was trying to defend Islam. He said, "Well, they have God, they just don't have Jesus." And I said, "Then they have nothing." It is not possible to have fellowship with God apart from Jesus Christ. All of these other religions, and there's many of them, who claim access to God are, it's part of this vain philosophy, empty deceit, according to the tradition of men that Paul was warning against, because